Mr. President-elect, when you reflect on what your father taught you about how a job is much more than a paycheck, I hear my own father, who raised our family in working-class Brooklyn. When he graduated from medical school during the Great Depression, he looked for a home and a place to hang his shingle near the Brooklyn docks. Back then, Bush Terminal on the Upper New York Bay was a thriving hub for manufacturing and transportation, and for the union workers whose livelihoods depended on them. Knowing they didn't have cars, my father found a home near a bus line. He started his family practice in the basement while we lived on the floors above. At the end of the day, he would talk to me, my brother, and my mom about what work meant to his patients, our friends and neighbors, especially if they lost a job, the financial problems, the family problems, the health problems, the loss of dignity and self-worth. The value of work always stuck with me, so much so that I became an economist, because I was concerned about the toll of unemployment on people, families, and communities. And I've spent my career trying to make sure people can work and achieve the dignity and self-worth that comes with it. Mr. President-elect, I know you've done the same. I saw that understanding during the last Great Recession and the Recovery Act that followed. And now we're facing historic crises again. The pandemic and economic fallout that together have caused so much damage for so many and have had a disproportionate impact on the most vulnerable among us. Lost lives, lost jobs, small businesses struggling to stay alive or closed for good. So many people struggling to put food on the table and pay bills and rent. It's an American tragedy. And it's essential that we move with urgency. Inaction will produce a self-reinforcing downturn, causing yet more devastation. And we risk missing the obligation to address deeper structural problems, inequality, stagnant wages, especially for workers who lack a college education. Communities that have seen industry disappear with no good jobs replacing lost ones. Racial disparities in pay, job opportunities, housing, food security, and small business lending that deny wealth building to communities of color. Gender disparities that keep women out of the workforce and keep our economy from running at full force. It's a convergence of tragedies that is not only economically unsustainable, but one that betrays our commitment to giving every American an equal chance to get ahead. But I know this team will never give up that commitment. As you've said before, Mr. President-elect, out of our collective pain as a nation, we will find collective purpose to control the pandemic build our economy back better than before, to rebuild our infrastructure and create better jobs, to invest in our workforce, to advance racial equity and make sure the economic recovery includes everyone, to address the climate crisis with American ingenuity and American jobs, working together with the outstanding national security and foreign policy team you announced last week to help restore America's global leadership. And above all, we share your belief in the American dream of a society where each person, with effort, can rise to their potential and dream even bigger for their children. I pledge, as Treasury Secretary, to work every day towards rebuilding that dream for all Americans. And to the great public servants of the Treasury Department, I look forward to working with you and Wally to rebuild the public trust. To the American people, we will be an institution that wakes up every morning thinking about you. Your jobs, your paychecks, your struggles, your hopes, your dignity, and your limitless potential. Thank you.